Good evening. This is the 9 p.m. update on Category 4 Hurricane Dorian. Dorian remains nearly stationary. In fact, it hasn't moved much in the last 18 hours and centered just to the north of Grand Bahama Island. Close enough that the eye is over, it's just to the north of the island, but the eye wall is on the island, and in fact, very close to the city of Freeport, where they're experiencing likely hurricane force winds now for 12 to 18 hours, and that could persist for another 6 to 12 hours before the storm begins to gradually inch away, either late tonight or early tomorrow. Once it does, we expect that the center will move towards the northwest, roughly parallel to the Florida coast, and actually take a track that will be roughly parallel to the rest of the southeast coast as well in the longer period. Here's the forecast track. Here's the coastline of Florida and the southeastern United States. The center's forecast to remain about 50 miles offshore, but just a slight deviation to the left, to the west, would make it much worse along the coast. On the forecast track, we expect tropical storm force winds all the way up the coast and hurricane force winds coming up right to about the coast. Those winds will be driving a storm surge ashore on the order of 4 feet along the east coast of Florida up through South Carolina. That's on the current forecast track, again with the center remaining just offshore. But if the center should be a little closer to shore, that will drive a stronger wind onto land, pushing a higher storm surge across the coast. 7 feet of inundation would be possible if that occurs. So for the next 12 to 24 hours, continuation of the really terrible conditions in the northwest Bahamas, followed by a gradual turn of the hurricane towards the northwest, then the northeast. Longer period, we'll have the storm parallel and close to the coast of the Carolinas. So there are potential impacts all the way from central Florida up through North Carolina over the next 3 or 4 days. Everybody who's in this zone at risk along the coast should pay close attention to the advice of emergency management officials. At the National Hurricane Center, I'm Ed Rappaport.
Okay,
great, thanks.